much. Thank you so much. I'm honored to be here today on this great occasion. 50 years ago, I was a 17-year-old boy in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, where my mother and father told me something great was getting ready to happen. And I couldn't play ball that particular day. It was a historical event, she said. It's going to change not only America, but the world. And then I began to listen to Dr. King and others as they spoke, and particularly with I Have a Dream. And I realized that Dr. King advocated for poor people. And if Dr. King was here today, I would ask him the question, if he was satisfied with the representation of poor people and poor folks being represented. And I came to the conclusion that he would be very upset and very disturbed. He would say that, Charles, we don't have anybody lobbying for poor folks. And it is because of the lack of people who are concerned about the least of these. People are suffering and they are hurting. He was saying that we must still hit the streets. We must still demonstrate. It was the SCLC, the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, that God gave us as a vehicle to free us. Now we must go back to ground zero. We must continue to march. We must continue to pray. Because through that experience, African Americans and fair-minded thinking folks of all ethnicity and background, the whole world is saying, teach us, my brothers and sisters, teach us how to get free. Well, I must say, freedom ain't free because we still must fight for freedom. Are you ready to march? Are you ready to go? Are you ready to demonstrate? We must hit back to the streets and liberate and free all God's children because God is love and love is what love does. We must free the people. Thank you so much.